again with another video, and it's your girl Key. Anyways, today we're gonna be doing a nighttime routine slash like girl talk 101. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. And if y'all want to know, I'm on FaceTime with my friends. Say hey, y'all. We've been on FaceTime for a good little minute. Don't mind my wig, it look crazy right now, but just catch me later on. I'm gonna do my makeup for my TikTok page or whatever, y'all. But yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing today. And the baby's already asleep. We ate pizza tonight, just to let y'all know that I didn't cook. And then I gotta give JJ a bath, pick out his school clothes, the whole nine yards. So without further ado, let's just get right into the video. Alright, y'all, we are in JJ room and I'm trying to figure out what is he gonna wear for school tomorrow. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick him out an outfit and then I'm gonna show y'all afterwards what I put together or whatever. Ain't gonna be nothing too, you know, too drip that. But I'm not really dressing him up like that because this is the last week of school before they start break, so it's like no point, you know. So I'ma just pick something simple, but yeah. So this is the fit that me and my friends picked out. He's gonna wear this green like knitted shirt with these blue jeans and then of course some black socks and his Jordans. So this is the fit. So yeah, this is what he's gonna wear, and then I'm gonna get back to y'all when I get Jetty out the tub. Listen to my niece. Say it again, Daisy.
Say no boss. Say it,
say
no
boss. What? She said what? She talking about what?
You gotta do it.
Don't do bow bow.
Say no boss.
Bow bow. Now say how to do the other one, Daisy.
Say bow bow bow.
Bow bow.
But what color? What color is that? What color is this?
Yellow.
Good job. What is this?
Turtle.
Turtle. What color?
Green.
Green. Good job. What is this?
A book.
Yep, a book. What color?
Blue.
Blue. What are these?
Green.
Grapes. What color? What? Yeah, there is a cookie right here. What color is this? What color is this?
Purple,
good job. What is this?
Pink.
Pink. What color?
Pink.
Pink. What is this?
Brown.
Brown. What is this though? Say bear.
Bear.
Good job. What is this?
Black.
Black. And what is this? Look, what is this? Woo-hoo. What's that? Woo-hoo. Say dog.
Dog.
What is it? Cat. And what color is it?
White.
White. Good job. High five. Yeah. Y'all, so I am back and I am doing my makeup because I be doing like little TikTok videos or whatever on my makeup page. But anyways, that's besides the point. So now we are at Girl Talk since I'm done with the nighttime routine for tonight. And yeah, so y'all basically wanted me to talk about the first topic was postpartum depression. And I honestly feel like postpartum depression is not something you can just easily get through or like get over. Like, it can happen any part of time of your life. Like, after you have your baby, while you have your baby. Like, you know, you just never know. But how I dealt with it is I talked to family. I talked to my husband. Just basically talking to anybody about it is going to do its job, okay? Also, some other stuff that you can do for postpartum is just find something that makes you happy. Like, it don't matter if it's, like, a hobby of yours, like drawing is one of mine, or reading books, you know, just something that's gonna take your mind up off it. But my main thing for postpartum depression would be to talk to someone that you trust or that you are close to, that you know won't, you know, tell everybody your business, and just vent to them about it. Like, I know some people be like, oh, I don't vent to people because I don't trust them. Find somebody you trust, vent to them, and it's gonna make you feel 1,000% better. Or even if you have a spouse or a friend, if you know your friend is depressed, take them out somewhere. Like, tell them just get dressed and take them out somewhere. Sometimes doing that with a person will help them feel so much better. So, yeah, that's really my big intake on how to deal with postpartum depression. Next thing I got asked to talk about was what is it like being married in the military? So, basically being a military spouse. I'm not finna keep y'all down. Now, honestly, I love it. Sometimes it's like a love-hate relationship because, let me just say this, like, I love it because we get to travel, you know, when we go to like PCS and stuff like that, and my kids get to see new places that they never been before. But it's like I hate it too because, like I said, you move a lot, so your kids can get settled into one place and then boom, y'all gotta up and move to another place. And then, if y'all didn't know, my husband is deployed right now. So, that's another, like, not ick, but, like, another con about being a military wife. And he's gone for 9 months. So, it's like, now I got to be here with the kids by myself. So, that's another downfall. But being a military wife is, like I said, it's a love-hate relationship. But I feel like since the days are getting closer, like, it's getting easier for me. And sometimes, don't get me wrong, I do break down. I do cry because y'all probably thinking, like, I'm always seeing her happy. Y'all, behind the screen, you know, sometimes things ain't what it seems. I do cry because simple fact, I miss my husband. But, yeah, like I said, it has its ups. It has its downs. It has its, it has its perks. My bad, y'all. You just got to figure out if that is the lifestyle for you. Like, I was in the military, so I know all about, you know, the military lifestyle and stuff like that. A lot of people have no clue about the military just because of the simple fact that, you know, they're either a spouse or they never, you know, dated somebody that's been in the military or never even been in the military. But I already know, like, what happened with it. So, it's a little bit hard and it's tougher on me because just because of the simple fact, I told y'all my husband is deployed. And when I got deployed, my baby, which is JJ, he went with my mom. So it wasn't as hard then. I think it's just as hard because I have two kids now. But yeah, that is my spin slash little take on how I feel about being a military spouse. All right, next topic is talk about fake friends and when you know you found a real friend. So, fake friends. Honestly, I would just say this because, you know, I don't bash nobody. I don't down talk nobody. I think certain people weren't meant to be in my life and some people was. I met people in the military that I wish I never met, and I met people in the military that I wish I would have met sooner who I'm grateful for. Good. But I would say it's a learning experience. Now, I'm not going to lie. I do have some things I need to work on, and like, as a friend. Because I know, like, a lot of people can't admit that, but I can. Friendship-wise. But most of the time, when me and a person fall out, it's because of some, some weird type stuff. That's all I can say. But with fake friends, I say you will know who's real and who's fake. Because either people around you that family, friends, well, not friends, but family or, like, somebody that's close to you, they can always sense when somebody's not for you, if that makes sense. So that's my take on fake friends. With real friends, hold on. With real friends, you will know you got a real friend. It's just basically like your instinct. Like, you will know. You will know when you got a real one. Because like I said, it's people that I've known since 2019 that we are still close to this day. And it's people that I know since then and that long that we're not friends to this day. It's just, I don't know, y'all. It just really comes natural. It just all comes out to what vibe you give off to people or you get from people. And also, like I said, with your loved ones, like how your loved ones feel about it. Because my mom don't try to tell me about a couple people. And y'all, I didn't listen. And I end up learning my lesson. Like they say, you live to make mistakes. I end up learning my lesson. But every time my mom has questioned a person or been like, oh, I don't really get a good vibe from them, I always used to brush it off and be like, nah, mama. Like, maybe you just need to get to know them, blah, blah, blah. And she ended up being right. So that's my take on that whole situation. All right. Next one is, y'all said, talk about the downs and ups of being a stay-at-home mom. Okay, so this is my spin on how I feel about being a stay-at-home mom. So, honestly, being a stay-at-home mom, I feel like I said, it's kind of like military wife type. Like, you got your good days, you got your bad days. Like, don't get me wrong, I love my kids, but there's some days where I be want to scream. Hold on. But yeah, it's some days where I want to scream and pull my hair out, and it's other days where I just loving it. But yeah, being a stay-at-home mom is really like a whole 9-to-5 job, because you wake up and you tend to go straight to your kids. Like, you basically, you know, care for your kids, get what they need, make sure the house is good, cook, clean, just all depending on what is your routine. But that is my routine. Being a stay-at-home mom, I wake up, take Jada to school, and then me and the baby chill here. And then, like I said, I'll clean up, cook. And then it's just a repeat thing. And since my husband's not here right now, I don't have to, like, really cook, like, big meals and stuff like that. But being a stay-at-home mom is pretty, like I said, you have your ups, you have your downs. It's really not, I don't know how to say it. It's really not, like, a negative thing about it. Now, one thing I can say, I am ready to go back to work, because your girl, like I said, I was in the military, so I'm used to going to work Monday through Friday. Now I just stay at home and take care of my kids, so it's kind of weird. And I've been doing this for like a year, but I'm ready to work now. I'm ready to get back into the work field and in the cut with my team. We be vibing. I'm trying to be out there vibing at work in this money on. But yeah, that's my spin/take on being a stay-at-home mom. All right, next thing that y'all said was y'all wanted me to talk about young marriage. Now, every time that I tell somebody that I am married and then I tell them that I am 25, they're always in complete shock, because I guess nowadays a lot of people are not married or, like I said, living a single life. But your girl is married over here, okay? I wanted to get married. Like, I had talked about being married when I was young. Like, that's how I knew the marriage life was for me, okay? Like, every time I tell somebody I'm married, they're just so shocked. Like, this society, people don't want to get married. They just want to out there live their single life, jump from person to person. And I honestly feel like it's way too many diseases out there to be trying to, yeah, do all that. And like I said, I wanted a husband. My man. Hold on, let's stop. Take a moment. Ow. But anyways, yeah, I wanted to, my man, my husband, this, my man, that, like, and I wanted a family. So I didn't want to keep living that single life. Like, okay, yeah, it was cool for the time being because I was young, you know, out there living my life. But at the same time, it's like, what you going to do when you get old? Like, you're still going to be out there being a player? You still going to be out there looking for the hoes? Like, come on now, bro. But yeah, I feel like young marriage, if you're ready to do it, go ahead and do it. Don't let nobody else decide what you want to do in life or who you need to be married to. Don't let nobody decide to decide that for yourself. And I decided when I was younger, I told y'all, I said, I'm going to be married when I get older. And that's really that. I love my marriage. Like I said, every marriage have their ups and downs. Me and my husband don't really like arguing, stuff like that. And I'm not going to get on here until I tell y'all all our business or whatever. But we don't argue and stuff like that. We have a good, like, relationship and marriage. And I love that for us. And like I said, we good at co-parenting with the kids. So, marriage was just meant for me. I cannot talk today, y'all. But don't mind that. But yeah, marriage was meant for me. I will say that. That is my take on that. All right, y'all. So that was my girl talk / nighttime routine. I hope that y'all loved it. I forgot to say in the beginning of the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Drop down in the comment section if y'all want to see more of this kind of content on my channel, because I really don't know what to be posting on here, y'all. But like I said, this was a good talk. This is how my makeup came out. I think it came out pretty good. But yeah, so I will see y'all in the next video. Bye. I love y'all.